everyone, my name is Katerina and I'm a second year student dietitian at Newcastle University, and in this video I'm going to talk to you about the advice that I would give to my 18-year-old self. So let's get started. One of the very first things that I would advise my 18-year-old self would be that for a girl who likes to have a plan, you're gonna have to take a lot of leaps of faith. Sometimes unexpected circumstances can throw us off balance. Trust me when I say that everything happens for a reason, even though now it doesn't really seem like it. This applies to all levels. Maybe something happened to your loved ones, maybe even something happened to you and this altered your path. But guess what? Human beings are meant to evolve and adjust, and you will too. I mean, clearly you're a weird kid with a different vision and outlook about life. And that's perfectly okay. In the end, you're right where you need to be with the right people by your side. When I started writing this script about this video, I was going more for generic things that I would love to say to my 18-year-old self. But I strongly believe that maybe a story is worth telling. So here it goes. Many of you might not know, but I'm actually doing my second degree. I have already completed a four-year bachelor's degree in Greece, where I studied business administration with specialization in hospitality and tourism industry. Let's just say that I took a leap of faith and decided to change my life completely, move to another country, do dietetics, which has nothing to do with business or tourism or hospitality or anything like that. I think I realized after the second year of my degree that I wasn't very happy with what I was doing, because I can easily adjust to any environment. I didn't really want to sit through it, but then the situation became unbearable. I started working in different hotels pretty much ever since I was 18, and this gave me a very good insight of what my life would look like after I graduate. I mean, don't get me wrong, it wasn't easy because the social pressure and what are your parents going to say and what the people are going to say. So I wasn't gonna leave my degree, I wasn't gonna drop out, but I just knew deep down that this wasn't for me. So once I graduated and this massive weight was lifted off my chest, I thought, okay, what's next? What are we gonna do next? Because I know this doesn't make me happy. And it wasn't just about persuading others to believe in me. It was more about persuading myself to hype myself up and believe in what I can do. I remember counting down the years that it's gonna take me to graduate and how old I'm going to be when I graduate. And I kept thinking that, oh, everyone else my age are going to have proper jobs and I'm gonna still be studying. And that really didn't stick right for me. But one day I woke up and I was like, no, that's it. I have to change my life. I am not happy. I can see all the signs. I am able to do this. I can do this. I have to believe in myself. So just like that, within 3 weeks, I had already moved to the UK and I started doing a course that I'm very passionate about. I couldn't be more grateful to my younger self who actually believed in me and said, you know what? This is not for me. I'm gonna chase up my dreams. I'm gonna do something different. I won't lie to you. Having to do biology, chemistry, and all that has been very challenging for me, since my focus towards business, economics, and high maths. But I'm so grateful to the people who took me seriously and who believed in me and gave me this opportunity to actually be here. I might need to study 10 hours more than other students, but every minute that I'm here, it's so worth it. And I couldn't be more grateful for all the choices in my life that led me here. I know that all the bad experiences and the situations that might seem like the end of the world is coming, it's actually the beginning of a new era. So I would highly recommend to follow your dreams, as much as cliche as it sounds. You're never too old to fulfill your dreams. If something doesn't stick right to you, trust your gut that there's something probably wrong there. So I believe in you, and you should believe in yourself too. I had so many other things written down that I would love to tell my younger self, but I strongly believe that this is one of the most important lessons, was actually to believe in myself, take a leap of faith, and just jump into the unknown, basically. But I guess if you think about it, this aligns with the fact that other people's opinions are a reflection of their own limitations, insecurities, and boundaries. So no matter what others think of you, or no matter what they say that you should be doing, you should always focus on what your gut is telling you and what you want. People's opinions are gonna be there. People are going to judge no matter what you do. Just make your future self proud of all the decisions you took when you were younger. And I'm gonna wrap up this video saying, don't try to please anyone besides yourself. So thank you all so much for watching. This was one of my favorite videos to make. The hardest one to film as well, but I'm very grateful you stick with me till the end. As always, if you have any questions, comments, and concerns, leave them down below or get in touch with us. Don't forget to follow us at NCL Dietetics, and I'll see you very soon in the next video. Bye!